المساجد لله وأن المساجد لله. The masjid belongs to Allah. The masjid doesn't belong to any king or any ruler or any khalifa or any trust body. The masjid belongs to Allah. It is His rules. It is His system that will apply in the masjid. Hadith Qudsi, Allah says, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah says, buyuti fil ardil masajid. Again, the word buyut, which is the plural of bayt, houses. Allah says, my houses on the earth, buyuti fil ardil masajid. Buyuti fil ardil masajid. My houses on this earth are the masjids. Ummaruha zuwaruha. Ummaruha zuwaruha. Those whose lives will revolve around the masjid. Those who will give their lives but never abandon the masjid. Those who are what we call ummarul masajid. Who are the ummarul masajid? Allah says in the Quran, innama ya'muru masajid Allah man amana billah wal yawmil akhir wa aqama as-salah wa ata az-zakah wa lam yakhsha illa Allah. Allahu Akbar. What a statement Quran makes. Allah is speaking of amirul masajid, those who will keep the masjid alive, those who are going to make abadi of masjid. Who are they? Quran says they have iman on Allah, they have iman on akhirat. They will establish salah, they will discharge their zakah, and they will fear no one but Allah. وَلَمْ يَخْشَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. The people that keep the masjid abad will fear no system, will fear no propaganda, will fear no lies, will fear no treachery, will not fall into the deceptions and plots of the enemies of Islam. وَلَمْ يَخْشَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. They will fear no one but Allah. They will first put Allah's system in front and then every other system. فَعَسَىٰ أُولَٰئِكَ أَنْ يَكُونُوا مِنَ الْمُهْتَدِينَ. Allah says, these are the people on hidayat. These are the people on hidayat. Who? Ummarul masajid. Ummarul masajid. Allah Ta'ala, hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, inna ummara baytillah hum ahlullah. Those who keep the masjid abad, those whose lives revolve around the masjid, those who will never give up the masjid. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, these are the family people of Allah. These are the household of Allah. Man alif al masjid alifahullah. The one who loves the masjid, Allah loves him. The one who loves the masjid, Allah loves him. The one who loves the masjid, Allah loves him. We want Allah's love. We want Allah's acceptance. إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُ الَّذِينَ يَعْتَادُ الْمَسْجِدِ فَشَدُوا لَهُ بِالْإِيمَانِ. My Nabi said, if you see someone whose life revolves around the masjid, then Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, give shahadat, bear testimony, he has iman. He has iman. Coming back to that hadith, hadith Qudsi, Allah says, buyuti fil ardil masajid. My houses on the earth are the masjids. Ummaruha zuwaruha. Those who will make the masjid abad, they are the guests. They are the guests. They are the guests. Who is the host? They are the guests. Who is the host? Tuba. Tuba. Liman tatakhara fi baytihi. ثم زارني. الله أكبر. حديث قدسي. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Allah says مبارك. مبارك. Congratulations. شاباش. To who? To the one who makes wudu at home. And then what should it have been literally? ثم أتى المسجد. ذهب إلى المسجد. دخل المسجد. جاء إلى المسجد. That's what it should have been. Then he made his wuzu, then he left his house, went to the masjid, walked to the masjid, approached the masjid, entered the masjid. Yet Allah doesn't say that. What does Allah say? Mubarak to the one who made wudu at home. Thumma zarani. Then he came to visit me, visit Allah. Then he came to visit me. And then what does Allah say? Fahakkun ala al-mazuri an yukrima zairahu. Allah says when he does this, he has a haq upon me, because now he is my guest and I am his host. Now he is my guest, Allah's guest, and Allah is your host. When you will make the masjid abad. Inna lil masjidi awtada. Inna lil masjidi awtada. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there are some people, this word that's found in the hadith, awtada is the plural of watad. What is watad? Watad means a peg. Why this analogy? Because once you drill a peg into the ground, knock it into the ground, it doesn't move. You can't shake it. You'll have to use great physical force to pull it out. This analogy. They are stuck to the masjid. You will never find them away from the masjid unnecessarily. They are the people of the masjid. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, in my ummah there will be some people like that. Otad will be the pegs of the masjid. What is their maqam? What is their status? Again, unfortunately we don't have that munasabat with Arabic. What it should have been in the hadith? Hum julasa'ul malaika. That's what it should have been. Hum julasa'ul malaika. They are in the company of the angels. Yet Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam didn't say that. He said, al-malaikatu julasa'uhum. Al-malaikatu julasa'uhum. Understand this by an analogy. Sometimes you hear some great Allah wala pious sheikh, alim, mufti, muttaqi has come to town. So what do we do? Quickly, we get together. You know what? Let's go and sit in the company of that sheikh, in the company of that Allah wala. Let's go and sit in his company because we will benefit. Inna lil masjidi awtada al malaikatu julasa'um. This is what it means. The malaika of Allah say, let us go and sit in the company of that person. The malaika say, let us go and sit in the company of that person. Al malaikatu julasa'uhum. In ghabu iftaqaduhum. If he is missing from the masjid, they go looking for him. In maridu aaduhum. If he becomes sick, they go and visit him. In kanu fi hajatin aanuhum. If there is any work that out of necessity has kept him away from the masjid. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, these people of my ummah are such, their maqam is such, that the malaika of Allah go and assist them to finish their work quickly so that they can come back to the masjid. My respected brothers, this topic, there's very limited time. In fact, we've already run out of time. But understand, unfortunately today we are in an environment where iman is weak. We are also, there were certain government regulations that brought about a situation wherein our masajids were closed temporarily. Obviously, Islam does not encourage breaking the law of the land. We have to keep the Shariat in front, but obviously we don't break the law of the land also. We work where we put Allah's law first, but we have to work with system. Don't bring badnami on the deen. So what happened? At that time, to placate those who truly left the masjid, one or two masail were mentioned. Instances where, very rarely, one time Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam commanded Bilal to say, "Sallu fi rihalikum," perform your salah at your home. Why? Was there was torrential rainfall? It was difficult for that one or two salah to come to the masjid. One time, one or two other instances they were. Like we find the Bani Israel were under the heights of zulm and oppression. So allowance was given. Temporary allowance. Those ahadith and those rare incidents were mentioned. My respected brothers. Sharab and pork also. In our Shariat there is a time when it becomes halal. When you're on the brink of starvation, you are going to die. It does not mean it is halal permanently. Nor does it mean the despicable nature of that is lifted. Circumstances conspired for that short time to make it halal. Don't fall into a trap wherein we look at those isolated incidents and feel that now that the masjid is open, okay, so there's some difficulty. Maybe I have to wait. Maybe there's some regulations I have to abide by. Let me carry on. I got into this mode of making salah at home. I got into this mode of making salah in my workplace. I got into this mode of where the importance and the ahmiyat of masjid came out of my heart. My respected brothers, this is a plea from the heart. Don't fall into that trap. Don't fall into that trap. Don't fall into that trap. This is the ummat of the masjid. As long as this ummat will make the masjid abad, as long as this ummat will give its life for the masjid, as long as this ummat will attach itself to the masjid, Allah's help will be with us. Otherwise, and I'm going to terminate on this. There were many other things I want to speak. Like I said, the time is limited. But I'm going to terminate on one authentic statement of a great sahabi. And there were many sahaba that said similar things. No time to go into the details. Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, Mu'az bin Jabal radiallahu anhu, other sahaba, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. But I'm going to mention the riwayat of Abdullah bin Mas'ud, and on this I will terminate. Kaan khol kar sun lena. Listen with the ears of Iman what Abdullah bin Masood radiallahu ta'ala said. He said, Man sarrahu an yalqa Allaha ghadan musliman fal yuhafidh ala haulai salawat haythu yunada bihinna. He said, that person who wants to meet Allah tomorrow with his deen and his Islam intact and his Iman intact. Abdullah bin Masood says to you, you want to meet Allah tomorrow as a Muslim, as a person of Iman. He said, protect under every circumstance your salah, perform it where the azan is called out in the masjid. Why? فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ شَرَعَ لِنَبِيِّكُمْ سُنَنَ الْهُدَىٰ وَإِنَّهُنَّ مِنْ سُنَنِ الْهُدَىٰ. Because Allah has ordained for His beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam certain practices to which Allah has directly linked hidayat. Allah has directly linked hidayat, divine guidance with certain practices. He said salah in the masjid with jamaat is amongst those practices. وَلَوْ صَلَّيْتُمْ فِي بُيُوتِكُمْ كَمَا يُصَلِّي هَذِهِ الْمُتَخَالِفِ عَنْ بُيُوتِكُمْ. He says, if you fall into this trap of starting to make your salah in your homes, not leaving out salah, making salah, but making in your homes, like certain people who stay away from the masjid. What does Abdullah bin Masood say? لَتَرَكْتُمْ سُنَّةَ نَبِيِّكُمْ. You have abandoned this practice of hidayat of your Nabi. And if you abandon it, وَلَوْ تَرَكْتُهُ. If you abandon it, Abdullah bin Masood radiallahu ta'ala says, لَضَلَلْتُمْ. You will be deviated. You will be deviated. Your Iman and your Islam and your deen will be in great khatra and great danger. Then he goes on to say, he says, the one who makes wudu at home, proceeds to the masjid on every step, Allah wipes away one sin. Allah gives him one neki. Allah elevates him one stage in akhirat. And then Abdullah bin Masood goes on and he says that there was a time, referring to the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where he said the only person who would absent himself from salah in the masjid is munafiq malumun nifaq. If sahaba wanted to know who is a munafiq, whose nifaq and hypocrisy is known, this was the gradient, that he does not perform his salah in the masjid with jamaat. That he does not perform his salah in the masjid with jamaat. And Abdullah bin Masood goes on and he says, even that person who couldn't walk would be supported on the shoulders of two people till he would be made to stand in the saf in salah. Abdullah bin Umm Maktum radiallahu anhu, a blind sahabi, says to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ana darirul basar. I am blind. I live distant from the masjid. Halli min rukhsa. Ya Rasulullah, he's addressing a mercy. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam was mercy from head to toe. He says, Ya Rasulullah, is there permission? An usalli fi bayti, that I can read my salah at home. What would our answer be? MashaAllah, in this contemporary academic age, what would our answer be? What does Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam ask him? Atasma'un nida, can you hear the azan? Can you hear the azan? This blind sahabi, who needs someone to guide him to come to the masjid, says, Ya Rasulullah, I can hear the azan. What does Rahmatul Alameen sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say? Ma'ajidu li rukhsa. Ma'ajidu li rukhsa. I cannot find any basis to allow you to make your salah at home. I cannot find any basis to allow you to make your salah at home. Circumstances conspired against us. This was a test. The test now is to re-establish our connection with the masjid. That is the solution. Whatever hardships this ummah is facing, learn from the ummahs of the past. Establish the masjid. Live in the masjid. Die in the masjid. Let our hearts become attached to the masjid. Become the people of the masjid. Make this masjid our home. May Allah give us tawfiq wa akhir da'wana. Alhamdulillah.